समारंभां शंकराचार्य अस्मदाचार्य पर्यंतां वंदे गुरुपरंपरां श्रुतिस्मृतिपुराणानां आलयं करुणानां नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। सहना भवतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः। यो ब्रह्माण विदधाति पूर्वं यो वेदाविश्च प्रणोति तस्मै तहुंहदेवमात्मबुद्धिप्रकाशं मुमुक्षुर्वै शरणमहं प्रपद्ये। ॐ शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः। श्रीचिद्घनगणेशाय नमो मह्यं सुखं नित्यं सप्रकाशं व्यापकं नामरूपयो अधिष्ठानं बुद्ध्यबोध्यं बुद्धेर्दुःखनिर्मलम् अपारं सर्ववेदान्तवेद्यं प्रत्यक्परं महः तदेवाहं न वक्तोऽन्यत् इति मे निश्चिता मतिः। पद्मनाभन जी kindly स्विच ऑफ योर वीडियो। कंटिन्यूइंग विद दी अन्यथा ख्याति एज पर नव्य नैयायिका। दी नव्य नैयायिका रिफ्यूट्स दी प्राचीन नैयायिका एंड सेज दैट the khyati that you talk about anyatha prakarantarena meaning what is seen really existent sarpa which is seen here and now is a bhranti that can't be because the sarpa which is vyavahita should also make up which being seen should also make the other things in line of sight visible as so because the other things in line of sight are not visible only the vyavahita sarpa is available that is illogical thereby anyatha is not in that manner but anyatha prakarantarani means rajju anyatha avabhasate rajju is seen in another manner they don't explain much but then it is seen in another manner they may explain in their chintamani ityadi but here prakarantarena anyatha is explained as rajju is seen in another manner it is not the vyavahita sarpa which is seen but anyatha means not elsewhere but the real sarpa elsewhere but it is the rajju which appears in the form of sarpa Now, Rajju is in the front and Sarpa is in the Buddhi. So, Jnana, we have Sarpa Jnana, whereas Padartha is Artha. Artha is Padartha. Padartha is Rajju. So that is also refuted by Akhyati because Nyadhinam Jnanam, Prameyadhinam Pramanam. You cannot have Jnana which is based on Prameya Vastu, Nyaya Vastu, Jnana is dependent on a Nyaya Vastu. You cannot have Nyaya Rajju, whereas Jnana is Sarpa. So Artha being Rajju and Jnana being Sarpa, it is improper. There is a disconnect. Viruddha Muchyate. So that was also refuted by Sankhyas and Prabhakaras, and then they established the Akhyati Matam. Where they say the sarpa is real and sarpa jnana is valid. Sarpa jnana is valid, rajju jnana, where idam amsha is seen as ayam, that is also valid. However, there is a confusion in the mind. So knowledge, none of these are invalid. There is no khyati, there is no erroneous knowledge if you take individual units. There is a smriti of sarpa. And there is Samanya Jnanam Ayam, Iyam Rajju, Iyam Idam Amsha is there. The only issue is there is a mix-up. why there is mix up? Because it there is a pramatru gata dosha and prameya, sorry, pramana gata dosha. So pramana dosha and pramatru dosha, due to that one is unable to see as two units of knowledge, but one has only one unit of knowledge, and that is the mix up as ayam sarpaha. The shishya tattva drishti asna tattva drishti pruchyati which among these four bhavadami abhimatam uttamam matam yat eteshu tadvada. So you tell me whichever is right among these four. I understand this khyati, khyati chatushtaya. There was a tippana there as to there is a satkhyati also, which has come up much later. I think Vishishta Advaitins use this satkhyati. Let's just quickly go through this. It's a little tricky, but we'll anyway go through that. We'll not look into details beyond what is mentioned here. Puruokta mata chatushtaya tirtam satkhyatihi iti panchamam puropaksha matam asti. There is a puropakshi matam asti panchamam. There is a fifth one which is not included in the four which we have discussed. It is called satkhyati. Tanmataritya satkhyati mataritya. There is the puropakshi mataritya, where they say it is satkhyati. Shuktau shuktyo avayavahi saha rajata avayavaha api sadavartate. So, you know, even if you think about science, scientifically, each molecule is separate from molecules of other chemicals, something else, other padarthas. Each padartha has its own molecular structure, where the, you know, the atomic structure is different. Atomic structure is different. Here, if you want to convert one to the other, you have to break that molecular structure and then reform it. Now, this is the idea that very scientific approach there. So, tanmataritya shuktau shuktyavayavaihi saha rajatavayavaha api sadavartate. Example given is shukti rajata. There is a shell and there is silver seen. Now, why is silver seen? They say it is satkhyati. Silver is also there. Why? Because in the basic atomic structure, everything is there. If you, in the molecular structure, there are atoms. You put together atoms, you put together the subatomic particles in a particular manner. You as a, whoever is the creator has the shakti to put together anything in any which manner. There are parts. So if you go to Anu level, this is why, you know, everyone other than Advaitin is basically a Tarkika. They'll use all sorts of Tarka to come to their pre-concluded notions. There is nothing which traces back to the Shruti. Where are the atoms as the cause of the samsara? There is nothing like that. In Shruti, there is no mention of Anu per se as the basic cause. One may talk about, you know, basic elements, Pancha Mahabhutas, but there is Chaitanya backing all that. They set that aside and bring about some kind of logical conclusion. It appears right, very scientific also, but still not based on Shruti. They should be ashamed to call themselves as Vedantins after taking, you know, the foundation being Tarka or some Purana Grantha Ityadi. However, we'll see for what it is. Satkhyati means there are Sat, the Padarthas are Sat. Why? Because the Shukti parts, Shukti Avayavaihi Saha, along with the Shukti parts, there are also Rajata parts. In the basic elements, whatever you consider basic elements, atoms, whatever, you know, there are parts of the, every part is there. Now, this is something that they'll accuse Advaitins also of, because Advaitins say avidya, ajnana. When you have ajnana, there are all kinds of ajnanas, stula ajnanas. You have mula ajnana which is swarupa jnana, and there is stula jnana, ghata jnana, pata jnana. Each and every ajnana is there. That particular ajnana is countered by the jnana regarding that vastu. So they say, we are not talking anything similar. In your case, there are all sorts of avidyas together. Everywhere there is all sorts of avidya. Only that particular avidya goes away. Thereby, you are able to see a particular vishaya. So ghata ajnana goes away, ghata avidya goes away, then only you can see ghata. Here what is happening is that ajnana, where you say avidya, ajnana has the basic components. They say shukti avayavas are there, rajata avayavas are also there, because basic elements are common at the basic structure. Sada vartate shukti avayava avayava vad rajata avayavaha api satyaha na mithya. Just like shuktika parts are real, the rajata parts are also real, because basic structure is same. Yatha shuktau dushta netrendriya samprayoga vashat siddhante avidya parinama rupa anirvachaniya rajatam tatkale jayate. So the Tippadakara is looking ahead. He is jumping the gun. He goes to anirvachaniya khyati. Anirvachaniya khyati says that avidya somehow transforms itself, viparinamate, avidya transforms itself into rajata. We'll see that next. Siddhante yatha avidya parinama rupa nirvachaniya rajatam tatkale jayate. At that moment, a rajata is born. Which kind of rajata? Rajata which is inexplicable, which cannot be categorized as inexplicable. Not that it cannot be explained at all. It cannot be categorically said to be real or unreal. It is that which is unreal but appears. That kind of rajata is born due to avidya. Avidya is the basis. Avidya undergoes a change. This is the Siddhanta, Vedanta, Advaita Vedanta Siddhanta. Yatha shuktau dushta netrendriya samprayoga vasha. Because there is a dushta netra, which is the indriya, it is connecting, there is a yoga, samprayoga. In some manner, it is connecting with the shukti, and thereby shuktigata avidya transforms into what? Anirvachaniya rajata, silver, which cannot be categorized to be real or unreal. During the pratiti, it is real. After the realizing, it is not trikala abhatita sat. It is momentary real. That is what is mithya. Tatha, similarly, is the satkhyati, meaning there is some parinama. That parinama is not due to avidya. They say, tatha atramate dushta netrendriya samprayoga vashat rajata vayavebhyaha satya rajatam api shuktau jayate. Not mithya rajatam. The difference is, we have mithya rajata, which is not useful. You cannot, if Advaitin says that I see rajata, there is no shell, there is rajata, you cannot transact with that Advaitin. Now this is what, you know, there are some who keep on saying, no, there is satya rajata, there is satya rajata, Advaitins as well as Vishishta Advaitins. Vishishta Advaitins has said that it is satkhyati. Whereas Advaitins have a different, they say it is there, real, it is elsewhere but seen here. To them, you can ask, you know, I'll give you shell, why don't you give me rajata? Why don't you give me silver? I've done that. Because there is no argument possible with them. If they say there is real rajata, okay, if there is real rajata, I'll give you real silver, vyavaharika silver. If it is not pratibhasika silver, I'll give you vyavaharika rajata. You give me vyavaharika rajata. Who will agree to that kind of a business transaction? Meaning it is all lip service. They don't have commitment to their own Siddhanta. Because if the silver is real, can they transact with that silver? If it is not transactable, how can it be vyavaharika satta? Let alone paramarthika. It is not even vyavaharika satta there, because you cannot transact with that silver. He doesn't have it. Anyway. So, tatha atramate dushta netrendriya samprayoga vashad rajata avayavibhya. Due to the rajata parts being there in the basic foundation, basic elements, दे कम टुगेदर एंड देन सत्य रजतम अपि शुक्तौ जायते. रियल सिल्वर इज बॉर्न देयर इन शुक्ति. नॉन ट्रांजैक्टेबल बट रियल. व्हाट काइंड ऑफ रियलिटी इज नॉन ट्रांजैक्टेबल? बुद्धि कल्पित ऑल कपोल कल्पित सिद्धांते अधिष्ठान साक्षात्कारात् अनिर्वचनीय रजत निवृत्तिवत अत्र मते शुक्ति ज्ञानात् सत्य रजतमपि स्वावयवेषु लीयत इति वदन्ति. देन हाउ विल दिस रियल सिल्वर गो अवे? दे से जस्ट लाइक यू यू आर नोइंग द अधिष्ठान रज्जु टेक्स अवे अनिर्वचनीय रजत. सिमिलरली इन अवर सिस्टम ऑल्सो से शुक्ति ज्ञान इफ यू नो दि शुक्ति देन सत्य रजत ऑल्सो गोज अवे. So there are two satyas. If you know one satya, another satya goes away. What kind of satya? God knows they have redefined satya also. In any which way, satya that goes away is not satya. Otherwise, you will not have satyameva jayate. It's not possible. But they have some argument. Just because, you know, we think so. There is no logical basis also. It is illogical. It is not Shruti Sammata also. Idam api matam. Heyameva. This also should be discarded. Even if we come up with some, you know, somebody comes with some new possibilities, all that has to be refuted. Shukti rajata drishtantena hi prapancha mithyatva anumitir jayate. When you know shukti rajata drishtanta, you understand that drishtanta well, then prapancha mithyatva anumiti. Anumana, this can be extended. This udaharana, which is just a sampling. We should not overanalyze the example beyond a certain point. Whatever is comparable should be compared. Oh, but Shukti and Rajata are at the same level of reality. This kind of argument should not be given because Rajata is there. Brahma is never there at this level of reality. Rajata elsewhere still exists. Although Rajata here is Pratibhasika, elsewhere Rajata is Vyavaharika. So that kind of a comparison should not be made. We should hold on to what is the purpose of the example, only those parts of the examples. And then you extend it, prapancha mithyatva anumiti hi jayate. Then anumana, anumiti is jnana, anumana janya jnana. Anumiti is prama. Prama rupa jnana jayate. Then the understanding, valid understanding takes place, valid knowledge rises. What is that? Prapancha mithya. Prapanchaha mithya shukti rajatavat. That is the anumiti which is born. Satkhyati vadetu shukti rajatasya satyatvat tadrishtantena na prapancha mithyatvam sadhetum shakyate. However, you use satkhyati, if you say, okay, it looks similar, some components come together and rajata is born. Yes, but one is, in our case, it is mithya rajata. In the other case, satkhyati, it is sad rajata. Sat rajata will not give you prapancha mithyatva. So you should not use such examples. Sadhetum na shakyate. Etan mata khandana parayuktya antarani. So etan mata khandana. This satkhyati mata khandana parayuktya antarani balanam durubodhatvat neha likhyante. They are not mentioned here because they are difficult to understand. We do not need those right now. So the khandana is not done. It is sufficient to see, you know, in the flow itself, we have seen that much khandana is sufficient. The author does not discuss it because there is involved tarka there. At a superficial level, we have used tarka and refuted it. That is fine. How can, you know, there is no example that one real jnana will take away another real jnana. That much is sufficient refutation for now. Now, akhyati mata khandanam. How do you refute the akhyati mata? Bhaya palayana adi anupapatya. So, bhaya palayana adi anupapatya rajyau sarpanubhava vachyaha. Now, if you have akhyati, meaning what? Akhyati is valid, which is the Prabhakara and Sankhya Mata, then what do they say? The jnana of Sarpa is there, but Padartha is Rajju. If the Padartha is Rajju in front of you and jnana is of Sarpa, then why do you fear the Padartha? you cannot run away. You cannot have fear. There is something in your mind, but does another know that you have fear? Let's say you are scared of snakes. That is fine. But just because you are scared of snakes and you are thinking of a snake, if there is a rope in front of you, you will not have fear from the rope. You may have fear in your mind, but you will not express that fear outwardly. You wouldn't run away either. So bhaya and palayana, fear and running away from that spot of Rajju will not be possible. Anupapatti, it is untenable to say that somebody recalls a snake and runs away from the rope, has fear of the rope and runs away from the soap, from the rope. Rajjau sarpanubhavacha. So there you have to explain how is there an anubhava which is smriti bhinna jnana. Smriti bhinna jnana is anubhava, whereas which is anubhava is at that moment. When you say I have anubhava, it is at that moment you have smriti bhinna jnana. So sarpa smriti bhinna jnana should be talked about. In the Rajju, you should have anubhava of sarpa. But you are saying there is smriti of sarpa. That smriti of sarpa and anubhava do not go together. Sarpanubhava is different from sarpa smriti. Because anubhava by definition is different from smriti. How can you have sarpanubhava in Rajju when you have sarpa smriti? This is contradictory even if you use tarka. Vachyaha should be explained. He somya brahmasthale. Asat khyatihi, atma khyatihi, anyata khyati, akhyati, iti etan mata chatushtayam api yukti virahitam. They are illogical. They have used every logic, but they are illogical. Yukti virahitam. In the Brahmasthala, where you have Rajju Sarpa, already said it is Brahma. It is Brahmasthala. In the Brahmasthala, none of these khyatis are logical. Says the Guru to the Shishya, hey Somya, he is pleased with the inquiry of Tattva Drishti and says, oh Somya, Purvokta Mata Chatushtaya Vilakshanam Anirvachaniya Khyati Namakam Matantaramasti Panchamam. There is a fifth Khyati which is not included in the four, which is Siddhanta, called as Anirvachaniya Khyati. Different from the other four. A fifth one, Tadeva Upadeyam. You should follow only that Anirvachaniya Khyati. None of these four khyatis. So the question was, which of the four khyatis is the best? Hey, none of those are. Forget best, they are Yukti Virahita. All those are illogical. Follow Anirvachaniya Khyati. Now, what is this Anirvachaniya Khyati? Purvokta Asat Khyatyadi. Purvokta Asat Khyatyadi Matatrayam No Upadeyam Iti. Akhyativadina darshitam. Why? First of all, why are the four in illogical? The illogicality, the other three from Asatkhyati, the last one, are illogical has been shown by the Asatkhyativadi. Not Asat, Akhyati, sorry, Akhyativadi. Sankhya and Prabhakaras have shown by Akhyativadina darshitam. The Matatraya, Khyati Traya are illogical and they should not be followed. That is the Akhyatibadi statement. Now, Akhyati, if you refute, Prathama Mallanyaya will refute the others also. But anyway, he has refuted everything else. That's why Sankhya is very close. So is Purva Mimamsa, close to Vedanta. They have built a very good foundation by refuting everyone who is in the close proximity. Then what remains is only Purva Mimamsa Mata or Sankhya Mata. We look at them and we refute them. Everyone stands refuted just by refuting Akhyati Mata in this case. Akhyati Matam api na upadanam arhati iti pradarshyate adhuna. Now, Akhyati Mata khandana is done. Akhyati Mata ritya ayam sarpa iti jnane ayam iti rajvatmaka adhishthana samanyausha pratyaksha jnanam. Pratyaksha anubhava. What is the pratyaksha? Pratyaksha is anubhava. Pratyaksha jnana is anubhava. What is the pratyaksha jnana of ayam ausha? Ayam ausha is pratyaksha. What is that ayam ausha? अयम सर्प इन दैट अयम इति अयम सर्प इति ज्ञान इन द ज्ञान दिस इज स्नेक देयर दिस दिसनेस अयम इति रज्ज्वात्मक अधिष्ठान सामान्य अंश प्रत्यक्ष ज्ञान दिस अयम डज नॉट बिलोंग टू सर्प सर्प डज नॉट हैव दिसनेस एट ऑल सर्प इज इमेजिन्ड नाउ दिस अयम अंश इज रज्ज्वात्मक अधिष्ठान अधिष्ठान ऑफ द रज्जु and samanya amsha vishesha amsha called rajju is not pratyaksha to the person who has brahma sarpa iti tu anyatra purva drushta sarpasya smaranatmaka jnanam iti sthiti whereas sarpa is smaranatmaka one it is also jnana but it is smriti it is recalled from memory whatever was earlier anubhuta purva drushta is purva anubhuta sarpa earlier you have anubhava of sarpa now it is not an anubhava of sarpa now it is smriti That is the case. इति स्थितिः तत्र पूर्वदृष्ट सर्पस्मरणमेव अंगीकृत्य पुरोवर्ति रज्जौ सर्पज्ञानानंगीकारे पुरोवस्थित रज्जुं दृष्ट्वा पुरुषा भीत्या न पलायेत वन वुडंट रन अवे जस्ट बाय रिकॉलिंग द अर्लियर स्नेक हैविंग सीन अ रज्जु इन फ्रंट वन वुड नॉट रन अवे बिकॉज स्मृति विल नॉट मेक will not cause an anubhava of sarpa in rajju. It will remain in the mind as smriti. There may be fear from that sarpa which is recalled. You may recall the moment when you saw that sarpa and the fear also you may recall, but you will not have fear from the rajju in front of you. Oh, this looks like sarpa. You know, you may pick it up and say, oh, this looks like sarpa. You cannot have fear from that rope though. Thereby you wouldn't run away. Purusha bhityana palayata. One wouldn't have fear and nor would one run away due to fear. Rajyum drushtva purusha palayata iti tu sarvajaninam. Everyone can see that this person has run away from this spot. Why? Because he has seen sarpa there. There is a sarpa anubhava. So sarpa anubhava rajyau vachya. Not in this smriti. Natu buddhau. तस्मात् पुरोवस्थित रज्ज्वामेव सर्पः प्रत्यक्षतया भासते इति न तु पूर्वदृष्ट सर्पस्मरण मात्रम् इति च वाच्यम् सो व्हाट हैज टू बी सेड पुरोवस्थित रज्ज्वामेव सर्प प्रत्यक्षतया भासते देयर इज अ प्रत्यक्ष अनुभव प्रत्यक्ष ज्ञान अनुभव ऑफ सर्प वेयर इन दि पुरोवर्ति रज्जु यू कैन नॉट से दैट इट इज इन दि बुद्धि एंड ही हैज रन अवे इट इज इललॉजिकल न तु पूर्वदृष्ट सर्पस्मरण मात्रम इति च वाच्यम वन शुड नॉट से इट इज रिकॉल्ड सर्प ड्यू टू विच वन रन्स अवे मेक्स नो सेंस वेर एवर ही रन्स अवे देयर इज अ स्मृति ऑफ सर्प इफ ही स्केर्ड ऑफ दैट स्मृति देन इवन इफ ही रन्स अवे ही हैव फियर इन हिज माइंड बट व्हेन अ पर्सन रन्स अवे ही सेज ओ आई एम नॉट नियर दैट सर्प व्हाई बिकॉज देयर इज नो सर्प अनुभव एनी मोर इफ द सर्प स्मृति हैज गिवन राइज टू सर्प अनुभव विच मेक्स हिम रन अवे He, wherever he runs away, there will be sarpa. Because sarpa is in his mind. Wherever he runs away, he should see sarpa. But he does not see sarpa when he runs away. That is another thing that we have to, you know, think, we can think ahead from this. Anyata rajyau sarpa jnana abhavena purushasya palayanadi naupapadyeta. It is not possible otherwise, unless he has sarpa anubhava in rajyu, he cannot run away. सर्पज्ञान अभावेन बिकॉज देर इज नो सर्पज्ञान इन रज्जु देर इज नो सर्पानुभव इन रज्जु ज्ञान इज अनुभव हियर बाध ज्ञान बलादपि रज्जौ सर्पानुभवाच्यः व्हाट एल्स बाध ज्ञान बलाद देर इज सर्प अनुभव बाध ही हैज सर्पानुभव यू कैन नॉट एक्सप्लेन सर्पानुभव इन रज्जु फर्दर व्हेन द टॉर्च इज शोन ऑन रज्जु The Sarpa Smriti being there also, Sarpa Anubhava is no longer there. Sarpa Anubhava wasn't there at all. But Sarpa Anubhava Vachya Rajyau Hau Bada Jnana Bala. The person who no longer has fear because a torch has been shown upon the rope, then this person does not have fear anymore. He says, I was seeing Sarpa here. Not elsewhere. I thought of the sarpa. He says, I was seeing sarpa here. Now I see that there is no sarpa. There is bada of sarpa. सो सर्पानुभव कुत्र रज्जौ एव वक्तव्यः वाच्यः नॉट एल्सवेयर किंच रज्जु याथात्म ज्ञानानंतरम मम मिथ्या सर्पो रज्ज्वाम अभात इति बाद रूप अनुभव बलादपि पुरुषस्य रज्जौ एव सर्पः स्वरूपतः प्रतीतः नतु पूर्वानुभूत सर्पस्मरण मात्रम अभवद इति वक्तव्यं भवति. सो टू थिंग्स, वन देर इज अ सर्पानुभव वेन देर इज भय एंड देर इज पलायन ड्यू टू दैट भीति. देर बाय ऑल्सो यू शुड से सर्पानुभव इज देर इन द रज्जु दैट हैज टू बी एक्सप्लेन. इट कैनॉट बी एक्सप्लेन बाय वन हू थिंग्स दैट सर्प इज स्मरण. सर्प स्मरण हैज टेकन प्लेस. सेकेंड प्रॉब्लम इज द सेम पर्सन वेन ही नोज दैट इट इज रोप then there is no fear because there is no sarpanubhava. Where was the sarpanubhava? He says that I saw sarpa right here. There was a sarpanubhava pratyaksha here. Now it I see that it is rajju. Therefore, there is badha. So due to badha also, sarpanubhava no longer being there, it shows that there was sarpanubhava for the very reason that he says, I do not have sarpanubhava anymore. There is no bhiti anubhava anymore. Why? Because no longer do I see sarpa. I see rajju. Therefore, also you should say that prior experience was of sarpa. So, due to two reasons, sarpa anubhava vaktavya kutra rajjau eva. Apicha ayam sarpa ityatra jayamanam jnanam ekam eva natu jnana dvayam. There are more flaws. So akhyatimata is not just refuted in this manner. They are very strong. So another flaw is shown. If there are jnana dvaya, earlier we have seen that logically you can have one samanya amsha and one vishesha amsha. You cannot have two visheshas simultaneously. Yugapad na jayate. Vishesha jnane yugapad na jayate. Two units of Vishesha Jnana cannot be born simultaneously. But here there are two units of knowledge as per the Puropakshi Akhyativadi. Nahi ekasmin kshane ekantakkarana vrittitvena smaranatmaka anubhavatmakancha jnana dvayam jayeta. There is a Vishesha here. What is the Vishesha? There are two different types of jnanas. There is one swaranatmaka jnana. There is anubhavatmaka jnana. There is idamamsha anubhava. There is Smarana also, but these are two different units of knowledge. Because Artha is different, Smarana, Jnana is different. So Artha Jnana and Smarana Jnana are two different Jnanas there. Tasmad Akhyati Matam Api Asangatatvad Anupadeyam Eva. That also should be discarded, it should not be followed. Why? Because Asangata. It is asangata, it is not tenable. Purvokta mata chatushtaya lakshanam tatkhandanadikancha vivarna swarajya siddhyadi granthesu vistarataha varnitam. So, purvokta mata chatushtaya lakshanam tatkhandanadikancha. What exactly is the mata of each of these four khyativadis in detail and their khandana in detail, their refutation in detail. We have seen refutation, the important points which are needed. We have seen what their perspective is and what the refutation is. In a logical manner, we have seen as well. However, if you want vistarata, if you want details, then he says vivarana, in vivarana sampradaya. So it's a multi-level tika level grantha. On Brahma Sutra Bhashya, there is Panchapadika on Panchapadika of Sureshwaraj. Of Sureshwaracharya, of Padmapadacharya, there is Vivarna. There is Vivarna. That Vivarna on which most of the, the Sringeri Sampradaya at least, and many follow Vivarna. Vivarna Sampradaya is based on that Vivarna Grantha. There and Swaraja Siddhi. Swaraja Siddhi is a Grantha by Bhagavan. Gangadharendra Saraswati, who was the Pitadisha Shankaracharya of the Swarnavalli Matha. Current, it was in the north, now currently in Sirsi in Karnataka. Even the current Swamiji is called as Shankaracharya, is I think Gangadharendra Saraswati Swamiji. So there was one who was there many generations back, he has written this Grantha. Not many, some generations back. This Grantha is now available in print. Lot of shlokas, very involved Grantha. Bhagwan willing, we'll see sometime. Vistaratha Varnitam, there it is discussed in detail. Tesham Matanam Swarupa Matra Jinyasunam Jnana Saukaryartham Tat Sankshipya Uktamatra. The very same refutation, the ideas of the Khyatis, Khyatibadis, as well as the Khandana of those four Khyatis are briefly Sankshipya mentioned here. What is mentioned in detail there, that itself is mentioned here. If we understand this, we don't need to go into details. Those who want details can and should pursue. Because doubt should not be left lingering on. Swarupa matra jidnyasunam jnana saukyarayartham tat sankshipya uktamatra. Those who are interested only in swarupa, swarupa matra, why any other pursuit using tarka can take you away? Why? Because if you are landed on swarupa, you don't need to go searching for aswarupa, meaning anatma. All this is in the anatma prapancha. If you have been able to refute and do not have doubts there, see, doubts can be academic interest. Academic interest is something else. If you have swarupa matra jidnyasa, whereby you do not have academic interest anymore, then jnana saukaryartham tat sankshipya uktamatra. It has been discussed here itself. We don't need any of this because we have landed on swarupa. If there is interest, you know, academic interest, pursue that. Or if you cannot land on swarupa, no, you still have doubts about those. No, I don't think this is right. Then also it is needed. But swarupa, if you can land on, then that is sufficient. What is sufficient? What is discussed here in this Grantha, that itself is sufficient. Siddhantino anirvachaniya khyati nirupanam. What is the Siddhanta then? You have refuted all four. There is anirvachaniya khyati, but I do not know what anirvachaniya khyati is. So that is elaborated here in 146 avarta. Anirvachaniya khyati lakshanam. What is anirvachaniya khyati? Antakrana vrittihi chakshuradikrana dvara bahir nirgatya vishaya samanakara bhavati. So antakrana vritti is dragged along with the indriya. The indriya, chakshu, drags the antakrana vritti and takes it along. So antakrana goes out. In the form of vritti, it goes out in the vishaya pradesha. Wherever the eyes can reach, up to that extent, the vritti can also reach. Antakrana vritti. Antakrana goes out. We do not follow the scientific approach of saying that, you know, the light enters the eyes and then there is an image formed in the retina. It's an inverse image and somehow buddhi corrects it. But still we know the structure also. There is a two-dimensional or a three-dimensional image. Still we understand the texture. We understand the distance at which it lies. We understand the size of the vishaya. All this we understand. We are able to make out in many cases, except in very, very, very few cases, rare cases of excellent artwork. We can differentiate between the photo and a real world out there. Three-dimensional world versus a three-dimensional picture also we can make out differences. How? Just by one image on the retina. It's a simple image in the retina. But that image can tell you the difference somehow that I see a picture versus I see a real existent thing outside. I can make out the texture, I can make out the shape, I can make out the size, I can make out the distance at which it lies. All this is possible just by one tiny image in the retina. Two, because there are two eyes. In comparison to the scientific approach where there is a lot of explanation needed, which is fine, but philosophically inquiring into it, philosophically we'll have different inquiry. Scientific approach is fine for vyavahara, but if you philosophically inquire, then the science has to explain. Philosophically, it has to explain how is it that you make out the texture, the distance, the size. There may be discussions there also, but What is the Siddhanta? In Siddhanta, the Antakkarana Vritti goes out and it takes the shape of Ghatapatadi. Not only Rupa, also Shabda Ityadi. Thereby, we know where the sound is coming from. What is the distance? We can make out the same amplitude. We can differentiate whether it is here or at a far distance. Loud but at a far distance. Here at a small volume, we can make out a difference. Because our Antakkarana Vritti has reached that spot. It has reached the spot where the sound occurs. Therefore, we can make a good judgment of the direction of the sound, the distance of the sound, what kind of instrument it would be. We can make some kind of a guesswork, which is an intelligent guesswork because our Antakkarana Vritti has reached there. Unlike, you know, Shabda, you know, bouncing onto our eardrums and then generating waves, etc. So philosophical comparison, scientifically it is valid, but philosophy, because there are a lot of instruments based on scientific theory which are working. We should take the philosophical approach because our interest is what? Swarupa Jinyasa. Landing on Swarupa Jinyasa through Pramana Vyavahara. So here what happens is that Vritti goes out and Vishaya Samanakara Bhavati, it just takes the shape Vishaya, which Shabda, Sparsha, Rupa, Rasa, Gandha, Akara. Bahir Nirgatya is only in the case of Rupa and Shabda Ityadi. Rasa is inside the Sharira. Taya Vritya, Vishaya Varana Bhange Sati. Then Samanya Akara, when it takes place, then Vishesha, what is there? Vishaya Varana Bhange Sati. Vritya, due to Vritti, the Vishaya Avarana, the veiling is destroyed. Ajnana, where there is a veil, Vishaya Upalabhyate, Sati Vishaya Upalabhyate, Vishaya is experienced, Anubhava is there, knowledge, the Jnana, Vishaya Jnana takes place, Rupa Jnana takes place, Akara, Samanyakara, Vritti takes away the Ajnana regarding that Vishaya, meaning Avarna goes away and then that Vishaya is known. Tasya Vrittihe Sauradhyalokopi Sadako Bhavati. So Surya Sambandhi is Saura. Saura the Aloka, the light. Sunlight. Basically, sunlight is also Sadaka. Sunlight is needed. However, if the sunlight is bright, you will in the Brahmasthala, in the Rajju Sarpa or Shukti Rajata, if the sunlight explanation. I mean, sunlight is used in the example only is discussed or is inquired into only in the Rajju Sarpa example. There you need a twilight zone. You need a dim lit zone. You cannot have bright sunlight. Otherwise, one will not see Sarpa, one will see Rajju. Shukti Rajata, you cannot use it because you see Rajata only in bright sunlight. On the seashore, if there is no light, you wouldn't see. There is dim light also, you may not see Rajata. There is bright light. Then only the Shukti shines forth. But in the Brahmasthala, in many Brahmasthala, Sauradhyaloka api sadako bhavati. Alokam vina padartho na prakashate. Both cases, there is light needed. If it is outside, then sunlight. We discuss sunlight. Any kind of light is needed to see at least. But it should not be bright enough to see Rajju. It should be bright enough only to see something exist. It should not be dark either. So, alokam vina padartho na prakashate. Tasmad aloka sahakari iti kramaha. Aloka is needed. Light is needed. It assists jnana. Pramana vyavahara. Just a second. Sorry. Rajvadu sarpadi brahmotpatti dashayam antakkarana vrittish chakshur dvara bahir nirgatya rajvasa sanyujyate. Now even when one sees sarpa, the eyes and the vritti are connected, eyes as in eyesight. The chakshu, there is indriya. Chakshu is not the socket, eyes do not go out, the eyesight goes out. The indriya goes out and having gone out, taking along the antakkarana vritti, what happens is that rajvasa sanyujyate. It connects with Rajju, not with Sarpa. There is no Sarpa. When it connects with Rajju, it forms a रज्जाकार वृत्ति सामान्य तथापि सा तम आदि दोषैः प्रतिबद्धा सति न रज्जु समानाकार भवति. So what happens is that although it takes the akara, it does not get the rajju akara. Rajju rupa jnana is not there. Tathasa tama adi doshai, because there is light but not enough light. Here it is said tama shabdena mandandakaro grihyati. It is a dim light. So when you say tama, it is not darkness, because in darkness you will not see anything, but you see something. Then that something happens to be sarpa instead of rajju. Tama shabdena mandandakaro grihyate tathahi प्रौढ़ प्रकाशे रज्ज्वाद्यधिष्ठानस्य विशेषांश अज्ञानं न जायेत. यू कैन नॉट हैव रज्जु अधिष्ठान प्रौढ़ प्रकाश. इफ देयर इज ब्राइट लाइट यू रज्ज्वादि अधिष्ठान रज्जु शुक्ति इत्यादि विशेष अधिष्ठान एंड देन विशेष अंश अज्ञानं रज्जु ज्ञान इदम इज नोन बट इदम Aumsha is known, seen, and Vishesha is not known. That cannot be the case. Because Prauda Prakashe Rajwadi Adhishthanasya Vishesha Aumsha Ajnanam Na Jayeta. You will not have Vishesha Ajnana. Rajju will also be seen if there is Prauda Prakasha. Gada Tamasi, if there is no light and there is heavy darkness, there is, you know, pitch darkness, then adhishthanasya samanya ausha jnanam api na jayeta. Then samanya ausha, you will not even know something is there. Idam ausha will also not be known. Therefore, you will need light, but not enough light. Adhishthanasya samanya ausha jnanam, vishesha ausha ajnanam cha, vina adhyaso naiva jayeta, iti dvitiya tarange avarte abhihitam. Without adhyasa, this kind of a samanya and vishesha jnana mix-up will not be possible. This has been dealt with in the second taranga, second chapter. Mandhandakare adhishthana samanya ausha jnana tad vishesha ausha ajnana yoho sambhavat tamas shabdena mandhandakara grahanameva nyayam. So when tama has been used here, it means mandhandakara, not total darkness, pitch darkness. It is established because there is a Samanya Aumsha Jnana and Vishesha Aumsha Ajnana. That is possible only when there is enough light to see Samanya Aumsha, Idam Aumsha, and enough darkness to see, not see Vishesha Rajju, Vishesha Aumsha Ajnana, meaning Rajju Aumsha Ajnana is possible only when there is Manda Andhakara. Netra Mandya Rupa Timira Dosho Api Tamas Shabdena Grihyate. Further, Tama can also mean Ajnana. That Ajnana is in the form of Mandya Rupa, Netra Mandya Rupa. The Indriya does not work well in dull light. That also is to be understood by Tama. Tamas Shabda. Adipadena Kacha Kamaladi Netra Rogascha Grihyante. So Tama Adi is mentioned. So there can be other Netra Rogas, which is not a general case of, you know, eyes not being able to see in the light is general case of the Chakshu's weakness, the field, because Chakshu is that way. But if you look at others, there can be as additional doshas also, like cataract, glaucoma, ityadi, squint eye, whatever. So tathapi sa tamadi doshai pratibaddha sati, saka rajju. Rajju pratibaddha sati, when it is pratibaddha, रज्ज्वादु सर्पादि ब्रह्मोत्पत्ति दशायां अंतःकरण वृत्तिश चक्षुर द्वारा बहिर्निर्गते रज्ज्वास संयोग तथापि सा तमादि दोषी प्रतिबद्धा सति. सो नॉट रज्जु हियर प्रतिबद्धा सति देयर वृत्ति विच हैज गॉन आउट इज प्रतिबद्धा सति न रज्जु समानाकार भवति. सो दैट वृत्ति सा इज वृत्ति नॉट रज्जु. सा वृत्ति समानाकार रज्जु समानाकार न भवति. It will not take the exact form of Rajju. Otherwise, the exact form of Rajju will give you Rajju Jnana. Tataha na Rajjo ho avarana bhango jayate. Thereby, Rajju avarana bhanga does not take place. Because of a dim light as well as Chakshur gata dosha, Pramana gata dosha, you can say Pramatra gata dosha also. Ittham avarana bhanjaka vritti samsarge सत्यपि सदा यदा दोषैः रज्ज्वाम् आवरणभङ्गो न जायते तदा अधिष्ठानभूत रज्ज्वावच्छिन्न चैतन्य निष्ठ अविद्यायाम् कश्चन विक्षेपो जायते. सो नाउ रज्जु आवरण भंग हैज नॉट टेकन प्लेस, विशेष अंश हैज नॉट कम टू लाइट, देर इज सामान्य ज्ञान इदम अंश. आई नो इदम अंश, आई नो देर इज समथिंग, देर इज दिस दिस एग्जिस्ट, समथिंग हियर एग्जिस्ट, इट इज देर, दैट मच इज नोन. वॉट इज इट आई डो नॉट नो एट दैट इवन क्रम, वी आर लुकिंग एट द क्रम, इट इज ऑल यू नो वेरी फास्ट. It is quite fast. We cannot, you know, in split second what has taken place. We are just looking at what is really happening there in that Brahmasthala. We know the Samanya Usha, but Rajju Akara has, the Vritti has not taken Rajju Akara because it is Pratibaddha due to Tamaha. And Tamaha is a loaded word we saw in the Tippana. Due to a lot of factors called as Tama, Rajju Vishesha Usha is not known. Thereby, itham avarna bhanjaka vritti samsarge sati api. Although vritti is usually capable to take away avarna, but still it is pratibaddha, it cannot take away avarna. Yada doshaihi rajvam avarna bhanga na jayate. And in such a case where there is no avarna bhanga of vishesha amsha of rajju, thereby Rajju not being known, what happens then? That is a field for avidya to cause havoc. Because the Rajju remains veiled. Once Rajju remains veiled, then the field is open for vikshepa to take place. This is the beauty in the Siddhanta. There is Avarna Shakti and Vikshepa Shakti. When can Vikshepa Shakti cause havoc? Only when Avarna is still there. That is why Jnani has Vikshepa, but it does not cause havoc. Because there is Avarna Bhanga. In the case of Atma, here in the Brahmasthala Rajju Sarpa, Rajju Avarna Bhanga has not taken place. Therefore, Vikshepa has its play. Tada Adhishtana Bhuta Rajju Vachinna Chaitanya Nishta Avidya. Avidyayam Kashchana Vikshepo Jayate. Then there is a projection, Vikshepa, there is some change. There is some parinama in avidya. Where is this avidya? Avidya is in Chaitanya. Oh, Chaitanya can have avidya? Yes. Because the reality of avidya is not the same as Chaitanya. Chaitanya is real. Avidya is mithya. It is karyanumeya. Maya, avidya is karyanumeya. Inferred due to karya. Yes, there is a projection, there is karana. Karana cannot be Chaitanya, Shuddha Chaitanya. Because Shuddha Chaitanya cannot do anything. So avidya has to be there. Where is this avidya? It is there in the very Chaitanya without affecting Chaitanya. This Chaitanya, where is this? Now with this Chaitanya, Chaitanya is all pervasive, single. Ekamaiva Dvitiya Brahma Chaitanya. It is also there in Rajju. So that Chaitanya which is there in the Rajju, segmented in the Rajju as though segmented. Chaitanya, which is Rajyavachinna. And what is that Rajju? Rajju is Adhishthana for Sarpa. Adhishthana Bhuta Rajyavachinna Chaitanya. This is Rajju. Chaitanya is Adhishthana. Adhishthana Bhuta Chaitanya. What Chaitanya? That Chaitanya which is Rajyavachinna. Limited by Rajju. You put a boundary. Which Chaitanya? Oh, the Chaitanya there. Chaitanya cannot be segmented. But you have to talk about, just like you say Akasha. Ghata Akasha 1, Ghata Akasha 2. Similarly, there is Chaitanya 1, Chaitanya 2. Here, though Avachinna. Avachinna has been mentioned. Avachinna Chaitanya Nishtha Avidyayam Kaschana Vikshepo Jayate. There is some modification that takes place in this Avidya and it projects the Sarpa. Tadasa Avidya Sarpa Karana Parinamate. We'll see more tada. We'll stop here. Tada sa avidya sarpa karena parinamate. Then there is a change in mithya sarpa coming up. There is a change in the avidya which is in the Rajju. Rajju adhishthana chaitanya. That chaitanya is an adhishthana for avidya also. That avidya undergoes transformation and there is a projection of sarpa. This is mithya, mind you. This is not like that satyati where there the components come together. Real components come together to give you real sarpa. Here it is mithya. So they steal away our explanation and they call it real. Why? Because they don't have a concept of mithya. Anyway, we'll stop here. We'll look at this further. Anirvachani khyati in the next paatha. I'm late for another paatha. Sukham nityam sa prakasham vyapakam nama rupe adhishtanam buddhya bodhyam buddhe drukyatnu nirmalam aparam sarvedanta vetyam pratyak param maha tadeva amnamattva nirti me nishchitamatihi. Om tat sat. Namaste.
Hari Om.